So here we go. Thailand coming up to a dangerous area, slowing you down. Can you hear that? That's it. That's all you need, because I could hear it from the rumble of the tires. I could feel it, vibration from the steering wheel. And that's all you really need. Instead of that ka-dunk, 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 all the way through a corner, which actually causes micro slips. In the wet, if you're on a bike, it's lethal. I've actually been on a bike on the after the Menora Tunnel, and those red rumble strips that go all the way around the corner, they actually caused the bike to micro slip with every passing, until a point where I was actually micro slipping off the road into the Armco barrier. So like I said earlier, what they have done, they've actually made a hazardous area even more hazardous. The warning for the hazardous area has made the area more hazardous. And that, to me, folks, is just absolutely stupid. You've actually made a hazardous area more hazardous. Now, okay, somebody actually commented it's to slow down the lorries. Hey, guess what? Lorries, buses, trailers, trucks, they have big tires with lots of rubber. They don't feel those red strips. So very, very often, I have seen cars slowing down for those red rumble strips, but the lorries and trailers and buses, they just go flying because they don't feel it. So there you go. It defeats the purpose. It absolutely defeats the purpose. Somebody else said, oh, they've sure done their studies and some intelligent studies. And of course, they would know to make it a little bit more grippy. Well, I'm sorry, but all the intelligent studies in the world will not replace actual experience. And I'm not talking about my experience as a driver. I'm talking about experiencing the drive while you're actually going over those strips. I don't care what you say, whatever studies you have done are not gonna be the same as actually driving it. So I just, listen, see, dangerous area coming up. It's so obvious, you see? And instinctively you slow down because that's an audible and a physical warning. You can actually feel it. So you know, you don't need red rumble strips going through the corner all the way. You really don't. In fact, it's like I said much, much earlier, and I will keep harping on this. They have made a hazardous area even more hazardous by putting on those red rumble strips going all the way through. What a beautiful building. Going all the way through a corner. In Thailand, like I am right now, you come into a dangerous area, you have visual warnings. Okay, there's a signboard there. Then this, it just tells you very subtly that you're coming to a dangerous area, you need to slow down. And sure enough, there are cars coming out. So that's it. That's it. That's all you need. You know, somebody else said it's to slow you down. I have seen vehicles, what a fantastic looking truck. Wow. I have seen vehicles flying over those red rumble strips. Because modern day vehicles with really, really good suspension, those strips are not doing anything to them. It's the slightly older cars with normal McPherson struts that are really suffering it. Listen, see, slow, slightly slower. And it's just a warning. That's all you need, really, really. So anybody from the works department who's watching this, or if you know somebody in the works department who's watching this, please, see, that's it. Just to tell you you're coming to a dangerous area. You don't need that. And why is dangerous? There's a pedestrian crossing here. So it's telling you there's a pedestrian crossing coming up. That's all you need, really. So, like I was saying, if you know anyone, just please forward them this video. This is all we need, really. Really. Those red rumble strips are doing no good for nobody at all. They are completely defeating the purpose. So yeah, that's it. Am I supposed to turn here? No, I'm still supposed to go straight. So yeah, hey folks, see, that's all you need. Just to tell you, yeah, there's a red light coming up. So hello, and yes, I'm in Thailand still. I'm on my way now back to the border. There's a nice C-Class there. So yeah, I picked this up. You know what these are? These are for actually keeping your car smelling nice. Not for your car to smell nice, because after driving for a very, very long time, you might start to not smell very nice. And this will actually keep the car very
pleasant smelling. So yeah, the bluebird's running beautifully. As you can see, the temperature is just stable. And the fuel consumption, oh my god, I only used half a tank from PJ to the border. Yep, that's all I used. Half a tank of fuel from PJ to the border.
In 200 meters, turn right.
And it's just been amazing on gas. Really, really has. But okay, so gotta go. Gotta find out what I'm doing now. Alright, talk to you later. Bye.